to revolution, to a revelation, limitation. Kings and queens and kings, welcome. I'm Michael and this is Ground Up Movement, chatting about spirituality, holistic health, the awakening, galactic knowledge, ancient knowledge, the power of word, the power of self, the power of thought, soaking up that prana, getting earthed out, strengthening my aura as the earth's magnetic field weakens and the Schumann resonance of the earth rises. The age of Aquarius is here. The new cycle begins. And of course, I am honored that you're here and I'm grateful that you're here. For anyone returning, what's up? And for anyone who's watching for the first time, welcome. The age of Aquarius is here. The great conjunction has happened. Time is not linear. It is cyclical. 1720. The Black Plague, 1820, cholera, 1920, the Spanish flu, 2020, the COVID, some kids call it the cove. What a shit show that's turned out to be. So a few videos ago, the Vision Quests, I covered 3D to 5D consciousness, the 12 steps of the Great Awakening, and explaining it in another way from another guy, and there's more ways to explain consciousness as well. And I've just thought I'd throw up four ways of explaining consciousness. First comes self-awareness. Second comes soul consciousness. Third comes galactic consciousness. And fourth comes sub-universal consciousness. So music's pretty important to me and I try to layer it into the videos as much as I can. That first track in the intro was from another First Nations artist, the original people. I continue to celebrate them because the more that I learn about this young nation's culture, what we consider to be young, really, it's so ancient and tied into advanced civilizations all around the world. The myths of Atlantis are now actually becoming substantiated as ancient history is being released or made known to the public through great works of gentlemen like Graham Hancock. Lemuria was a nation that was once in the Indian Ocean and it was actually connected to Australia and to other land masses up north. The DNA of the Aboriginal people and the Papua New Guineans has been discovered in South America. And it wasn't through traveling down through Northern America across Iceland like it was once believed, because the DNA doesn't show that. But what it does tell is that the bloodlines of this nation's people are across there, and they had the technology and the know-how to cross those oceans. The gold plating on the pharaohs in Egypt has now been found to have come from Australia. The Gosford glyphs, hieroglyphs in New South Wales, thought to be too unreal to be real, tell a true story of the ancient history of the world, which means this nation's people, the first people, are tied into all the advanced civilizations of the past. Isn't that amazing? And before we go any further, I just need to say, you are loved. You are sovereign. You are here for a reason. And you are special. So the last video I did was about scribing and affirmations and all that sort of stuff. And I just picked up a new oracle deck and the first card that flew out of the deck was this. So we love a little synchronicity, that backup from the universe. the kookaburra sings in the background. Millions of people are waking up to the information that we create our world through thoughts, through words, and through our emotions. That our words and our thoughts affect everything, and that our emotions attract what we are thinking. The collective consciousness rises, as does the consciousness of Mother Gaia's, and the animals, and the plants. We are electromagnetic, energetic beings. Give thanks. Show gratitude. The healing of the DNA at the telomere. The activation of the crystalline body. We can heal ourselves. We can heal others. We can manifest amazing things into our lives. A change in energy is here. And as systems start to fall down, and they are, something beautiful is sure to emerge. Shout out to all the light workers. You are protected. You are the chosen ones. And I actually got a deck here, which I pulled a card for myself, but I've been told to share this with the collective. So I'm going to chuck that card up now and read the affirmation, the invocation from this beautiful deck that I've got. By the divine authority in me, I intend to create, attract, and enjoy, for all the greatest good of all, a life of abundance in love, well-being, fulfillment, joy, and wisdom. I am willing to take the journey to grow into the fullest expression of my beautiful and true self. May these words be divinely empowered to create my reality. Love, peace, happiness, trust, surrender, strength, grace, prosperity, discernment, and joy. May the power of voice and decree, the power of spiritual authority, always be tempered with grace and divine mercy. Through unconditional love and my own free will, so be it. The new world is here. The new knowledge is here. The old knowledge is coming back. And I'm so pumped to be part of this awakening. The social media game, good, bad, and ugly. The ugly? Well, what we've found is that if you're a bigot, if you've got anxiety issues, if you're angry, if you're low vibration, social media will expose that in you. Bad is the censorship. Facebook is not an information sharing platform anymore, if it ever has been. It's no good for sharing videos. It's no good for sharing controversial information. It's no good for sharing anything that isn't the narrative of the mainstream. The fact checkers of Facebook have now been found to be partially paid for by an arm of TikTok, which is owned by the communist China. The head board, the overseeing board of fact checking for our discernment, for our protection, is again partially owned by an arm of TikTok, which is communist China. The Great Awakening hashtag is deleted. You cannot use it on Twitter or Facebook or anything. So now people are writing hashtag The Awakening. So that's the bad of social media, just to touch on it. Facebook have also just been revealed to have put $500 million into funding the opposition to President Trump in the election. And that's more than the government spent on the election. So we can see what's really bad about social media. YouTube is censoring anyone who uses the word fraud and this and that to report on what's going on at the moment. Hundreds of sites were deleted before the election over there. The inquiry into social media giants and how they work with each other has come out in the Senate hearings over in the US and has proven that they've got particular software that traces people and where they go and what other sites they go to, and then they're sharing that information with Twitter and so forth. So yeah, this shit's real. Social media has got a lot of negativity to it, but kill all that noise. What about the positive side of it? Almost forgot to blaze up and get smoked out. Use sage and Palo Santo to cleanse our energy field, suffocating the inorganic and anything AI related with this sacred smoke, helping to transform emotions of anxiety. And that ringing in your ears, you're not going crazy, you're just waking up. Shout out to the koalas, getting their bush sexy times on. So I run Isagenix, and links to my store are underneath. And the men's multivitamin pack that I'm running at the moment has definitely made my sex drive healthier, as well as having additives for healthy brain function like turmeric and ashwagandha. But don't believe me, I've attached a video from another awakened, intuitive, divine masculine master teacher, Michael Jaco, who was 25 years in the special forces, an author, and heaps more. And in that vid, he interviews another awakened conscious business owner, and they discuss brain health and the pineal gland. It's similar to the stuff that I've been sharing in my last two videos. And I'm also rocking some tiger's eye, which is fantastic for cognitive function. Social media for the conscious creator, using a broken system for good despite the fuckery being exposed and probable mass migrations from these oligarchs. If you're not using socials, you're still on point, don't get me wrong. Amazon, Google, and Apple completely wiping Parler off the map. The domain is gone. The app is gone. 20 million users and a small startup business not allowed to play with the big boys because they allowed for free speech. $51 million wiped off the share market for Facebook and Twitter for banning the president of the most powerful country in the world. And they don't care, which shows how much money they're willing to soak up to control information for our safety. Globalists, they're trying to bury us, not realizing we're seeds. So, the social media positives: creating brand for free, creating a legacy for free, a legacy of giving value and information and positivity to raise a vibration. When you're learning through either a course, a seminar, a book, a video, or for your own journey, if you can share this information in your own way, you are solidifying what you are learning, or double learning it, or super learning it. So whatever you're into, whether that be raising the consciousness, or economics and trade, working on cars, photography, playing an instrument, the list is limitless. But if you can do this consistently with purpose and passion, in 5 years' time, you'll be that guy or you'll be that girl, as long as you are willing to stay focused on what you love or what you would love to do
or who you would love to transform into. And yes, you are giving away free intellectual property, but all the benefits are free also. And in the quantum economic system, everything that you give out freely for the greatest good of all shall be rewarded. You don't learn through consumption, you learn through creation. Shout out to Jim Quick. I shared him in the last few videos. He's a bit of a lord. And you can create a circle of people around you that you want to learn from and who you want to emanate for free. If your friend circle of friends or your economic status or you're locked away, you're locked in, you can use socials to create that circle. So my YouTube vids, I'm using to practice public speaking and being creative. My Unfxck My World Facebook page is an example of super learning and a way to navigate the Facebook blocking and shadow banning of life-changing information. Plus, you can always go back on your learnings and self-reference. Look, I could go on for ages about this, but there's always time for another video. So we'll just keep it moving. I'm Michael Jaco, and this is Ground Up Movement. Thank you for watching. Wishing you abundance in material gains, trade, giving and receiving, synchronicity, inspiration, imagination, and creativity. Peace. Much love and light. Stay tuned for more madness. May you step into your power and be divinely guided. Namaste.